Hey everybody, I'm Destin Legends and welcome back to our Let's Play of Spain, where I believe last episode we actually just were defeated in our campaign against Genoa, which sets us back quite a bit. We're now 200 gold in the hole, but you know, I'm not going to rage quit over that. I am awfully upset with Genoa. We are going to get a revenge on them, but I guess our current goals are basically, well, we have to get ourselves out of debt right now, which means no more war for a little bit, so we're going to be mainly focusing on politics. We can probably still acquire some of these territories just by offering vassalization. Genoa, I'm really not happy with how much they've encroached into Spain, but I still am controlling the greater chunk of it myself. Barcelona has a little bit of a chunk. Aragon and Castile, well, Leon has completely broken up. And Navarra, hardly worth mentioning, but they have actually caused some trouble for me in the past. Actually, as did France, they actually assisted Genoa in the defense against me in the last war. Britain's still kind of messed up as well. Roman Empire holding strong together. I guess there is a crusade going on right now. I don't think I am a part of that officially. Well, I guess I am officially part of the crusade. I just don't think I've sent any troops over there. And is it a crusade or a jihad? No, it's the Catholic Crusade for Sicily. So I guess the Catholic nations have all banded together and decided they are tired of Islam running into Spain. Or, not Spain, I'm sorry, into Italy. So they've decided to do something about that. So I guess we're going to get timer rolling here. And actually, this sound effect was really loud, but I can deal with that. Actually, I think that the audio in this video is going to be a lot better. I've been trying to improve it as much as I can with every single video. But actually, yeah, that is actually really, really loud sound effects. So I'm just going to turn that down a little bit. There we go. So it looks like I actually need a new counselor position. I don't know why my marshal seems to have retired or something. I guess I can give it to this guy. He has a lot of negative traits, but none of them are really that bad. I'm not really sure. Yeah, none of them are particularly bad for Marshall anyway. He just doesn't really entirely like me. Which probably it won't be a problem if it's just my Marshall that doesn't like me anyway. I'm just gonna... Age 25, Prince Alvaro. Portugal has died maimed and crippled. I wonder how that happened. Well, now, was that my heir? I'm not entirely sure. I will check into that. I'll just send my marshal to research some military technology. And that was actually... No, that wasn't my heir. That was the pretender. So that's not that big of a deal, but now I just have one male heir. I have a daughter as well. I'm not sure if females can inherit under the laws that I have right now. Women can inherit, but only if there is no eligible males. So yeah, I have a male and a female heir right now. If, you know, worst comes to worst and one of them dies. So I've just gotta give it a couple months to get out of the hole here. So I don't really want to start another war. I think I have some claims. No, I have no current claims. Let's actually slow down time. Start offering these guys some vassalization. This guy says no. And mainly because there's a small difference in our rank. He is a duke, I believe. And how about you, sir? Offer vassalization. Says no because I'm not his de jure liege, but I am working on that. But my coffers are empty and I've already borrowed money from my friends. Perhaps it's time to approach moneylenders. Once the usury's a sin, we'll pay it off on our own. We're gonna suffer a little bit of a penalty from how much vassals like us mainly. But you know, we'll just deal with that for now because I don't want to be paying any interest to anybody. And why can I not offer you vassalization, sir? You were involved in a war against this fellow. But that's not really my concern right now. What is my concern, though, is this guy right now. He's currently involved in an embargo war against... Oh, good. This might not be good. This guy I was just checking out. It says, to the Russian King Mundo the First, may you be sewn up alive in the belly of a dead camel. This is a formal declaration of war. Our armies shall meet on the battlefield. So this could be a problem for me. Actually, you know what I could probably do here? I could probably get a holy order in here. Yes. So this won't cost me any money. It'll cost me 165 piety, which will take away from like my overall score and a little bit of like how much some people like me. But I really need these guys to help me defend. I don't even think that my army itself is fully up to snuff anymore. I don't think that this is my full, like the entirety of how many troops I can raise overall. I'm not sure, maybe that is it, maybe it's only 8,000. But I think, let's take a look like right here for a second. I mean, this guy. They don't actually, they still kind of like me quite a bit, my vassals. I thought maybe my vassals might not have liked me because I was in debt so far. But we're just going to raise our own troops. We're not going to bother our vassals for their troops over this right now. And hopefully, I've got almost 1,000 guys here, that'll be enough. I will get my vassals' troops in on this if I have to help me defend. What is he even... Ooh, the invasion of Andalasia, which is actually a really big mass of land. I guess he's trying to take this entire mass from me. I guess it's just this entire mass. So yeah, we're not gonna let that happen. That would set us back way too far. And sorry if you can hear my chair squeaking there. I really have to invest in a new chair. But that's messages here. That's why you guys have to subscribe, because it helps me out and I might get like another couple pennies from ad revenue, and yeah, then I could buy a new chair someday, maybe. But we've got a message here. Okay, I'm sorry, I don't mean to say subscribe to me and give me money. I'm just saying, hey, subscribe, because videos, I'm just killing myself here, so I'm gonna shut up about that. So to the Honorable King Mendo the First, subscribe. Blessings upon your house. Your cause is righteous. Please accept my offer to join you in the armor of it. Invasion of Andalusia. Subscribe. So yeah, this guy wants to subscribe to my channel. So we're going to accept him and let him join. I think, which one is he? It's one of these guys, this guy. So he's coming to subscribe to my channel and help me in this war. And we should unpause that. And to the Honorable King Mendo the First, peace be with you and your cause is righteous. This guy wants to join me as well, so we're gonna let him in. It is the Duke of Leon. And so I have some friends here, it looks, that's great. But of course they're probably worried, I'd be worried too. Because if the Sultan down here does actually get this territory from me, he's gonna be extremely powerful. It wouldn't hurt to see Mali come up here and attack the Sultan either, but that probably won't happen anytime soon because he is currently involved in his own war and I'm still in debt. That really hurts. I'll never forgive Genoa for that. It was more France, because I basically had Genoa beaten the last war. You can always go back to the old video and watch it. I think it was the previous episode. Yeah, I had nearly won the war, and then France comes down to help him out and shuts me down and makes me a sad panda. And I can probably cut this army off here. But nah, they can run amok in Spain right now. That's not really my concern. I'm gonna come down here before anything. And actually, I'm just gonna expand that group right there. Oh, it's too late. Maybe this 1500 guys will get there in time. And it looks like I actually have like a bit of a morale boost anyway. And it looks like I did actually win that minor engagement. The enemy there must have actually probably retreated because they saw extra 1500 guys coming. And now we're gonna come back down here. We're not gonna wait for the Sultan to come to me. I'm going to go to him and attack, attack, attack. Probably try and smash his army. Actually, after I beat him, assuming I will beat him, I'm just assuming I will, because it looks like I have the stronger force currently. He'll actually probably be forced to pay me a bunch of monies for losing the war. And then, yeah, that might make up me like going in debt that badly. At least I hope so. But for now, we're just going to march around, destroy his armies, and I guess micromanage our kingdom. There's not really a whole lot going on. Could create the Kingdom of Galicia, but that won't do me any good at all right now, except give me extra prestige, which I don't really need right now. King's actually about 60 years old. He might actually die sometime soon. And I'm sure. What does that guy want to do? Wants to see the Duchy of Seville granted to a new ruler. It's currently held by my son, but actually, I could probably tell him to end his plot. End plot. Yes. Okay, so that'll protect my son completely from the guy trying to take away Seville from him. Which, again, is this little area down here that I fought so ever hard for. So my coffer's empty, but the church is rich. Maybe I should seize church properties to repay my debts. That sounds like a terrible idea. There are fat bishops. Seize them. That would give me cruel. And Prince Archbishop Fernando will not sit silent while the church law is violated. He would give me 300 gold, though. That would be sweet. But I'm not gonna, like, muck about and force, like, the church to pay for what was essentially my mistake anyway. Times are harsh. Force the church to share the cost, which I could do that. Or compromise with them to find money. That's actually not that bad of a deal. 50 gold, I lose a bit of prestige, but I get piety. Both of which I need, gold and piety. Or never. I will save my Christian soul, which would give me zealous. A bunch of piety. Lose one stewardship, but yeah, we're actually gonna compromise with him. Get the gold and the piety. Everybody wins. Oh god. Okay, this is actually... Yeah, let's pause quickly. It's probably too late. They're gonna arrive on the 11th of December. Oh boy. This is gonna be rough. If I don't win this battle, that's gonna mean huge things. Really the negative things. It'll really make the war really difficult to deal with. A message here, though, from the Duke Abel of Kraboba. He says he's going to stop his scheming against my son. And I'm not going to read every message word for word, just because, you know, they get really old. Especially if you're following the series or you follow Crusader Kings, you know, like semi-regularly at all. Then you've probably heard and seen the messages like over and over anyway. And this is really good. This is exactly what I want. I was so afraid that this little battle might not work in my favor, but it looks like things are actually kind of swinging in my favor. I probably won't have to, you know, bother my vassals still, or their troops. Maybe I should just for insurance? Oh yeah, we got like an excellent victory there. I probably can't force peace on Body Guy yet. No, he still thinks he's winning the war, which is just silly. What's this here? Message to join the war. To the magnificent King Mendo I. You would like to join the war. That's this guy here. We're gonna accept that. All support from our Catholic brothers in Spain is greatly appreciated. Even though we're pretty much winning it now, we don't really need it, but I'm not so prideful to turn down help when it's being offered. Everything helps. And I'm almost out of debt, that's great. And I don't know if I want to do one big long episode now, or if I want to split this. I will probably do like a half an hour episode. I'm not really sure looking at the time right now. We'll just see how it goes. I'll record until I'm done recording. That sounds good to me. Subscribe. See, if I think if like I like work like that subliminally, you know, it might get to you guys, and yeah, it might happen, and I'll get all the subscribers on YouTube and be the most subscriber-rich commentator on YouTube. But, you know, whatever happens, happens. Of course, I've said before, and I'll say it again. Like, I mostly just do this because I really like video games, and I play video games, so why not record them anyway? And, you know, I'm really into esports. If I can grow esports, and I guess, like, video gaming in general, that's something that I want to do. And, you know, of course, the more support I get, the more I am able to do that. Like, I'm not in this to make money anyway. Like, if you think you're gonna make money on YouTube, you're gonna have a bad time. There's just no money here. Like, maybe not. Like, not for me anyway. It doesn't seem like it. Where was I going with this? Oh yeah, and like, you know, like, even like, probably like shortly in the future, like, you know, I'll even like put my, can't really say money where my mouth is. Like, you know, I don't monetize all my videos, and I'm actually planning on doing like a series of videos where I don't monetize anyway. So, you know, it's not all about the monies. It is kind of all about the fans and the subscribers. Not that I really have fans. I don't really know if you could call my subscribers fans. Maybe they are, but, you know, I think they're just other people that enjoy video games like I do. And, you know, that's all that I really want. And we're gonna win this battle. Gonna crush him. And then maybe he'll accept peace. Maybe he'll surrender. And I'm actually gonna try and commentate a ton tonight, because I'm afraid I won't be able to do much in the next week because I'm going out of town for the weekend. I'm going to a very special anime convention in Toronto, Canada. I am Canadian, if you were not aware. I've got a prisoner. Don't know if he's going to be worth anything, but we will definitely find out. And where's Buddy Guy going now? He's going up there, so we'll follow him. What was I talking about? Yeah, I want to commentate a bunch tonight, so I might even just do one episode of this, then do some Zomboid. And getting some Guns of Icarus up on the channel. That's probably something I'm going to be doing regularly. Of course, let me know what you want to see, because, you know, of course I'm going to play whatever games I want to play, but I'll try and upload things that you want to watch. So if you're into Crusader Kings 2, you know, let me know, and we'll be uploading a lot more of that. If you're into Project Zomboid, let me know if you want to see a lot more of that. If you are still sticking around from the StarCraft days and League of Legends, you know, there is definitely more StarCraft and League of Legends on the way. But, you know, if you definitely give like me a shout out and request more of that, I will certainly do it. I've just been kind of hanging off. You know, like, haven't gotten any StarCraft 2 up for a while because of the Heart of the Swarm. I actually have not purchased a copy yet, so I don't really want to keep on commentating Wings of the Liberty stuff. One Heart of the Swarm is out. But anyway, that's a little rant off on the side. I've got a message here. It says, where am I? Who are these people? Oh, pretty colors. So I think my king is actually going to die soon, so that's going to be something I'm going to have to deal with. He's become infirm and incapable. But, it looks like I have my spy master has been appointed my regent. That sounds like a terrible idea, making my spy master my regent. He's club-footed, humble, cruel, patient, craven, and deceitful. So yeah, he's not ambitious or greedy or anything, so I don't really have to worry about him messing things up for me while my king is currently dying. But I guess I'm feeling really good about this war. We're out of debt. I think it's been a good episode. I don't know how long I've been recording for. At least, hopefully, a half an hour. But I won't really know until I've ended this recording and checked. I am going to stop this episode here and look forward to, I guess in a way, forward to King Mando the Cruel passing on in the next episode. It'll probably happen. We don't really know. And winning this war, in a way. Like I said many times this episode, please subscribe, and I probably won't hound you guys that much in the future about it. It's just, it seemed like the thing to do. Like a famous YouTuber, or semi-famous, Jesse Cox says, advertise like a shameless whore. And on that note, should I say, I'll see you next time.